Dear viewers, warm greetings. Welcome to the channel. In this video, I'm discussing about how to draw mind map, how the mind map is useful for learning, how the mind map is useful for presentation, how the mind map is useful for writing, and how the mind map is useful for teaching, how effectively we can make use of learning, and how it is helpful for learning, and the types of mind map and types of mind map softwares available for the mind map drawing. Swiss Army knife, all of you would have heard of. In a single pack of the Swiss Army, we could able to collect plenty of knives or tools or set of gadgets. So this mind map is a Swiss Army knife for the brain. In a single sheet, it is possible to bring the entire textbook content. In a single page, it's possible to bring all the facts and informations and pictures for the effective presentation or brainstorming or presentation, writing and teaching and learning. Let us start with learnable intelligence. What is learnable intelligence? The learnable intelligence is the terminology coined by Dr. David Perkins. Everyone bonds with neural intelligence. It's a minimum intelligence. Every newborn kid will be having neural intelligence. How this neural intelligence developed over the period? This learnable intelligence only helps or allows the neuronal intelligence to develop wider and wider. This learnable intelligence is a combination of experiential intelligence and reflective intelligence. What is experiential intelligence? Anyone is getting experienced with certain instant, certain skills or certain activities. For example, playing a chess, driving, writing, problem solving skill, coding skill, puzzles. Anyone try practicing again and again over the period, a person can become expertise in this particular activity or particular instant are handling things, then it becomes experiential intelligence. Reflective intelligence, everyone will be aware of their own thinking patterns and they will be tracking how the way it changes and what is the way they are connected with each and every phenomena. Everyone will start introspecting themselves. When the combination of experiential intelligence and reflective intelligence becomes more and more, learnable intelligence becomes more. Learning becomes simple. Learning becomes easy. Now in this slide, I'll be discussing about mind mapping principles. How one have to draw the mind map, how to start, how to end up, and what are all the phenomena or principles we have to consider while drawing a mind map is the topic of discussion in this slide. Always start in the center of the blank page. Your brain has more freedom to spread out in all the directions. Use an image or picture for your central idea. Image stimulates your imagination. Image creates interest. Image keeps you to be focused. It helps you to concentrate. Use colors throughout. Color adds excitement to the brain. Color adds vibrancy and life to your mind map. Color adds energy to your creative thinking. Connect main branches to the central image. The brain works by association. The brain likes to link things together. Connect second and third level branches or as many as levels possible. You can keep connecting and spanning out. Linking the branches creates structure. Make more lines curved. Straight lines are boring. Curved branches are attractive. Use one keyword per line. Single keyword gives your mind map with more power and flexibility. Each word or image creates its own association and connections. Each keyword is able to spark off new ideas and thoughts. Use images throughout as much as possible. Use more images in a mind map. Single image speaks 1,000 words. When we include more and more images in a single mind map, it speaks a lot. It gives more connection. It gives more association. It gives more imagination. How the mind map helps in learning. What are all the advantages of using mind map? How it improves learning? How it improves thinking? That is the discussion in the forthcoming slides. Mind map is a brain compatible thinking method. Mind map helps to assimilate information more quickly. It helps to grasp information and facts more quickly. It gives strong stimulus for interlinking the concepts. It enables visualizing information as a core skill. Mind map helps to create better learning environment. Mind map enables joyful learning. Mind map reduces complexities and it will be helpful for effective presentation. It's an in and out technique. It's useful for outlining written documents. Mind map helpful for storyboard presentation. Mind map enables critical thinking. Mind map as well enables reflective thinking. Reflective thinking always will have question for a particular topic. What was easy? What was hard? What did I learn? How will I use it in the future? How we are doing things and what are all things working on to us? Reflective thinking turns experience into insights, improves reflective thinking. Mind map improves reading comprehension. Brain learns easily through association, categorization, and classification. Mind map helps connecting with several facts by establishing association, categorization, and classification. Mind map allows to skim the text and enables easy reading. Provides holistic picture for the concept. Mind map allows to increase the retention rate, benefits the student's achievement. It's useful for brainstorming session. Mind map supports cognitive learning theory. Too much of information fed to memory at a time will lose the focus. Always filtering the information what we require and feeding the limited amount of information. It is possible through mind map. Mind map improves parallel learning. Let us discuss what is parallel learning in the next slide. If we look at the slide, it gives the complete picture about resistors in series, capacitive reactance, decibel formulas, and what are all the formulas used in electrical engineering. It gives parallel learning. Looking at one thing at a time, brain learns quickly, remembers quickly. When information becomes too much, naturally, person loses the focus towards association, clustering, fetching, connecting things. Which formula is to apply for the particular problem? People will get confused. When the brain looks at several things at a time, naturally, brain associates things in the better way, categorizes, classifies. Then later on, brain easily could fetch information relevant to the given instant, relevant to the given information. That is the advantage of parallel learning. Let us look at this slide also. This discusses about DC bushless servo motor, DC brush servo motor, DC stepper motor. It gives the complete classification towards the topic, strengths and weaknesses of these three motors. When the brain looks at all the three motors at a time towards the attributes, strengths and weaknesses, easily learns things, easily connects, easily classifies, easily associates and categorizes. This is the power of mind map. It enables parallel learning. Learning many information or many facts, many types at a time. I would like to say it as parallel learning. Circuit symbols. When the brain looks at all the systems, all the diagrams, all the symbols at a time, easily connects things in the better way rather than learning sequentially. when anyone learns AC current separately, DC current separately, they could be able to understand easily. Once if we put up a question, or once if we give you a problem, picking different methods, then everyone will get confused. To avoid that, everyone should look at many information or more facts in a single stretch or in a single map or single slide. Then naturally, it enables, it boosts the parallel learning. Mind map types. Let us discuss in this slide. Types of mind maps. True mind map, introduced by Boozen. It is said to be Boozen mind map. Common mind maps, concept map, mindscapes, tree diagrams, logic diagrams, or Venn diagrams. This is example for true mind map. This is example for common mind map. This is example for concept map. This is example for mindscapes. This is also example for one of the mind map. It's example for tree diagram. It's example for Venn diagram. Now, I would like to introduce one powerful website, Printerest. This is a website has collection of visual discovery, collection of mind maps, collection of storage tools. In a single page, it speaks a lot. Classroom language, prepositions of place, 57 senses to use in your writing, ways to say thank you, outlining your novel, list of free apps for education, 280 ways to say different set, and phonics, learn to read and write with phonics. So many, plenty of mind maps on different themes. It allows to learn things easily through visuals. It has numerous pictures. It gives more attraction. Printerest has variety of categories. These are all the categories. One such category is home decor. It has a lot of visual collections for home decor. It has critical thinking skill. What is critical thinking skill? In a single mind map, anyone can discuss or present about critical thinking skill. It has numerous mind map for engineering also. From the same website, I have taken this picture, the different styles of learning: verbal, physical, logical, social, solitary, visual, oral. This is the URL for printerest.com. https://in.printerest.com. Who introduced mind map? Are you curious to know about it? Historically, Leonardo da Vinci is the person introduced mind map to the world. Leonardo da Vinci uses mind map and mirror writing to express his ideas and thoughts. In the year of 1452 to 1519. And in the modern era, Tony Boozen is the person introduces the digital mind map. He is also an educational consultant, mental literacy. iMindMap is a software he introduced to the world. He is dedicated himself towards refining the techniques to help individuals think better and creatively to reach their fullest potential. Applications of MindMap. MindMap helps to prepare notes or cheat sheet for the entire lecture or for the entire presentation. Notes for text and books, unit-wise also, a teacher can prepare mind map, or for the entire course also a teacher can prepare mind map. Notes for talks and discussion, project management, knowledge management, exam preparation. How to choose the digital mind map software? Flood of new mind mapping softwares in the recent years. To find the best one to meet your requirements, it's certainly helpful to try out and test a number of softwares in the beginning. Or you should get an advice from the expert which mind map is useful for suiting your particular thoughts and courses. You should then decide on package for creating your mind maps. This is a mind map blog I referred during this presentation. And choosing a software, I'm listing few softwares, free softwares. XMind is one of the free mind mapping software. Eminet Mind Map is one of the free mind map software. Concept Draw Mind Map, Avis Thought Mapper, Free Mind, really free. In the forthcoming video, I'll be discussing about the demonstration for the free mind map, how to use the software free mind map, and how to download the software free mind map, and how to draw the mind map using free mind software. iMindMap, MindJet Mind Manager, these are all the softwares freely available. You can make use of it. I'm listing here very few. These are all the references I made myself for this presentation. And Mind Map Scientific Research and Studies, you can go through this URL. Free Mind, where to download? Use this URL to download the software Free Mind based on the platform or operating system which you use. It lists various operating systems and the way to download for each and every operating system. And this is the command. You have to use a command prompt to type the Free Mind when you use the operating system like Ubuntu and CentOS. Java-jar, the path of the jar file, /freemind.jar. This is the file you have to execute, or this is the command you have to execute or to open the Free Mind jar file. Only then you can get the entire user interface for drawing the mind map. This is example where in my workplace Vedic, I used to give this command for opening the Free Mind software. Wish you all success. Keep watching. Subscribe the channel. Thank you.